Brock on tenor sax and lead vocals. Andre Lewis on keyboards. Bill Street, Jerry Ted Colchino on drums. Roy Estrada on bass.
Thank you.
hair evenly distributed all over its charming dog-type body. This hair, God made this hair in such a way as to make it appear to be evenly distributed all over the body of the aforementioned poodle. And then God made two big mistakes. The first one was called man, and the second one was called woo man. Woo man, there's one now. Woo man, looketh upon the poodle. Exhibit A, the poodle. Woo man looketh upon the poodle and saith unto herself, I don't quite like it with the hair all the same. So she turneth to the man, and she saith to the man, as only a woo man can, she says, sucker, go get a job and make some money so that you can bring unto me a pair of clippers with which I might modify the aforementioned poodle. Whereupon the man, being the chump that he was, ventured forth into the world and got a job. Shortly thereafter, the man received what was purported to be a paycheck, even in those days. He took his miserable little paycheck and went to a store and bought a pair of scissors. Brought these scissors home to the woo man, whereupon the woo man grasped the scissors and simultaneously grasped the poodle. Thusly, and clippeth upon the poodle in the thorax, the managua, the medulla oblongata, and right around the chops here, leaving just a little bit of, a tasteful bit of foot showing at the bottom. And these are the four desperate little corners of the poodle. And then she took the aforementioned poodle and placed this poodle in a quasi-erotic, even for Australia, this is a quasi-erotic poodle position that I will now demonstrate. For those of you who can't see the poodle because he's too little, he's sitting like this. Then woo man placeth her legs in a position as if they were reaching heavenward in a gesture of supplication thusly. And looketh deep into the eyes of the aforementioned poodle and said these words, which I'm sure you'll cherish for the rest of your day.
Oh, Thank you.
Thank you. novel. Ladies and gentlemen, this is a true story. You may not believe it, but it's true. Some of you might know already that America is a peculiar kind of a place. And as America's goodwill ambassadors to the world, it is our duty to present to you the finer points of American life. During this particular year, 1976, you might know that the people in that wretched country over there are going absolutely berserk with souvenirs, trinkets, and all kinds of things to commemorate the fact that their country is supposed to be a really hot shit. Well, ladies and gentlemen, let me tell you, there's some wonderful things in America, but most of them never get out to the public at large and the rest of the world. Now, for instance, when your mind drifts to the subject of great Americans, what do you think of? Richard Nixon, J. Edgar Hoover, Richard Helms, all those kind of people. No, there is somebody even more advanced than that, and that's what our song is about. This song is about Michael Caine, the unsung hero of the 20th century. Here's Michael's trip, ladies and gentlemen. Michael was known for the last 10 years as the infamous Illinois Enema Bandit. What he had done for Enema Bandit, as you might say it down here. Michael had this little thing that he liked to do with college-educated women. He would get a briefcase, and he would walk into their house with his briefcase wearing a ski mask. And in his briefcase, he would have a gun, a thermometer, some rope, and various types of Enema equipment. Then he would tie the college-educated woman up, face down, on some sort of appliance, and then he would reach into his briefcase and pull out the thermometer. The thermometer he would then lubricate and stub in, pull out, glance, whiff, reinsert, and stick it back in the briefcase. Thank you very much, Michael. And as soon as he had taken the temperature, he would take the bag and dash off into the toilet and fill the bag with hot water, whereupon he would re-enter the chamber where the woman with the college education was tied up face down and would take the nozzle of the aforementioned Enema bag and ram that sucker right up her butt and pump her full of about 2 quarts of hot water. Yes, it was certainly filling for Michael. Whereupon Michael would then jack off all over himself or have himself a little homemade wank if you prefer and tell the girl at gunpoint not to call the police for at least 5 minutes until after he had left, and then he would disappear. Michael Caine was arrested and tried and convicted and sentenced, and that sucker is in jail right now proving how wonderful the law is in the United States of America. And how wonderful it is there. And they got him in Chicago in December. He's doing about 20 years now on 5 counts of armed robbery because apparently there is no law, even in our country, against giving a college-educated woman a cosmically oriented internal rinse job. His big problem was that in the process of pumping them up, he would rob the ugly ones. So you should never do that. And this is the story of the Illinois.
Thank you. I'm gonna see you tomorrow.
your thumb. That's all those suckers up there. Look at that. Doesn't take any talent whatsoever. Just maybe three or four stupid little muscles in the arm and the hand. Just hold up your thumb. This is the rock bottom of audience participation. This is the bottom line. This is, without a doubt, the singular, most primitive form of audience participation that anybody on this continent is liable to experience for at least the next 15 minutes. Hold up your thumb. And if you don't, you won't have as much fun as the ones who do. And for those of you who might be a little bit... you can hold up your toes if you like. We're not particular. Just do something to let us know that we're in Sydney. Thank you. Thank you. Like a dog until you finally grab them. Thank you.
Thank you.